Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Somesh Kumar. So today we will start a new course and the course title is Internet of Things. So the first chapter of this course is Internet of Things, definition, its vision, concept and application. So in this lecture we will study about the basics of Internet of Things, what is the meaning of internet, what do you mean by things, and what is the its importance, what is its applications, its visions. So all the basic things of Internet of Things will be covered in this lecture. So our first lecture is its basics of Internet of Things or fundamentals of Internet of Things. So what is important at this stage to exactly understand what do you mean by Internet of Things? So basically Internet of Things consists of two words. First is Internet, second one is things. So what do you mean by first Internet? So Internet is a vast global network of connected servers, clouds, computers, tablets, mobiles, devices and systems. All these devices are connected with the help of one global network that is called the Internet. So in the Internet uses the internationally used protocols, various protocols and connected systems are a part of the Internet. So what is the main use of internet or how the internet works? Internet enables sending, receive the data, send the data, receive the data and communication the information between two edges or between two points. Also with the help of internet, we can send the information between devices, various sensors, servers, applications or business processes. So everywhere the internet is used. So Internet of Things. So things may be the virtual things or maybe the physical things. So things may be any type of things, whether it is the electrical things or mechanical things, whether it is persons, whether it is physical object or an activity. These are called the things. So Internet of Things, the basic definition is all these things connected with the help of internet. This is called the Internet of Things. And currently or 9 billion things are connected to internet till now. In future, probably more than 20 billion things to be connected with the help of the internet. Here the things may be the physical object or the virtual object. So virtual objects are those objects which are intangible, means you can't see those objects. For example, your e-books. E-books is one good example of your virtual things, or electronic paper, fine or e-paper. Everyone today is reading the e-books. So this is one example of the virtual things. How the e-books is connected with the help of the internet. So this is the one example of our things. So all these things connected with the help of internet is called the Internet of Things. Basically, from my point of view, it is better to say internet for things. Means the internet used four things. So it is not wrong when we are saying internet for things. So Internet of Things, internet for things are the same here, fine. So we can say it is internet for things or internet of things. So this is the basic definition of our IoT. So here I want to give one more example of IoT. Suppose anyone, any person or any faculty enter in the room. When you sit on the chair, then automatic your chair sends you and automatic your system start up. This is one example of your IoT. And suppose you want to read the books in your laptop. When you enter in the room, your light automatically switch on, and when you sit on the chair, your laptop automatically switch on, and automatically your ebooks opens in your laptop. This is one very good example of our IoT system. So here your virtual object, that is your ebooks, your physical object, your laptop is connected with the help of your internet. With the help of all these things are connected with the help of one particular thing, that is called the sensor. So this is one very good example of your IoT. So I already told you, so internet IoT can be used anywhere, any network or any services or businesses or anyone or anybody, anything or any device, any time or any context. So here any word is very important, means any services can be provided with the help of the IoT, any devices can be connected with the help of IoT, or in any conditions. The only requirement is the internet. Fine. So as this figure says, anything, any device, anywhere, any services, any businesses, any context, any path or any network. So due to this, it is called the global infrastructure for the information society. So in the global infrastructure means the information, not only about the creation of information. In the global infrastructure for information society means it's all about the creation of information, manipulation of information, and access to that such information in the right manner. So in the IoT, all these globally infrastructure are connected with each other. So we can say the IoT is the network of physical things or object that are embedded with the help of electronic software, sensors and etc. Fine. So all these physical devices or electrical devices are connected with the help of internet or with the help of the sensors. So one examples I already told you about the person, relationship between the chair, person, light, laptop, e-paper. So here the e-paper is example of your virtual objects. So with the help of internet, these two physical objects are talking to each other. Physical object means chair is talking to your laptop is talking to your chair, and your laptop is talking to your ebooks. So with the help of IoT, these two physical objects can communicate with each other. So interconnect. So basically this internet works of things is not a single technology. In this, various technologies are involved. This is IoT is the embedded of all these technologies. So these physical devices can be various type. Basically this can be have different configuration, different specifications. So every times every physical objects have the different specifications, and all these other technologies, for example, all these systems are connected with the help of the cloud technologies. So your internet can fetch your data, and this data can be stored to your cloud. So cloud technology also can be used in the IoT, big data, machine learning, computer visions. So all these technologies combinedly built a IoT system. So IoT enablers. So first one is RFID. So first concept of IoT is used in your RFID. Your RFID is one which we know in the marketplaces, at different places in the society, this RF technology is used. For example, in your cars, RFID is used. You have listened, RFID locks. Where also this RFID can be used. So RFID is the first technologies used in the IoT. So next technology is your nanotechnology. So currently, due to the lack of spacing, we are seeing every sensors the size is reduced day by day. This is all due to only nanotechnology. Currently we are saying nanocapsule. So nanocapsule is used inside our body to scan our internal body organs. So for example, when we are saying nanocapsule, nanocapsule size in the nanometer, when any patient swallow this capsule inside the body, then automatically it scan our internal body parts and send this information outside with the help of the internet. And also due to the space constraint, we are saying our sensor size is reduced day by day, called the nano sensors. This is the most important enablers for the IoT. Next one is sensor. Sensor is basically the backbone of the IoT. For example, if you want to measure the temperature of one patient and send this information to our system or our server room or on the cloud, so this can be done with the help of the temperature sensor. Suppose you want to measure the humidity, then we have to use the humidity sensors. Humidity sensors send this data to the one intermediate technology, for example, with the help of Arduino. So this sensor sends the data and send this information to the Arduino, and Arduino send this information to the or server or on the cloud with the help of the internet. So sensors is also one of the most important enabler for IoT. Next one is the smart network. Of course, for better IoT system, we need the fast internet or the smart internet system can be used for the IoT. So these different nano devices, nano capsules are going to talk to each other. The other basic definition of IoT is the IoT is the network of physical object that contains embedded technology to communicate and sense or interact with their internal states or the external environment. Right? Next one terms is the smart hyper connected devices. So basically the hyper connectivity is the use of multiple system and devices to remain constantly connected to the network, social network and streams of the information. Means when all these devices are connected constantly without any disconnection, that technology or those devices are called the hyper connected devices. So these smart devices are constantly connected to the network. So for example, in the street light network, so street light basically always connected to the central controlling station. When there is no daylight, then automatically this street light gets on. So all these street lights is constantly connected to our station services. And second one example is RFID. RFID always constantly connected to the central controlling station. So these are some examples of our smart hyper connected devices. So IoT vision. So basically IoT vision is a vision where all the things, whether it is wearable watch, alarm clock, home devices, surrounding objects, physical objects, virtual objects, become smart and behave like the human beings, so that they can communicate with each other, they can communicate the information to the human beings, they can communicate the information to the central server station. And the second reason is a region where embedded devices interact with the remote objects and persons through connectivity using internet or near field communication or other technologies. So these are the IoT vision. Next one is the characteristics of the IoT. First characteristics, the IoT system should be efficient in nature. It has to serve efficiently the requirement of the application. For example, if you want to design an IoT system which automatically sends the weather information, so the IoT system should be efficient to collect this information and send this information to the central system. So efficiency is one of the most important characteristics of the IoT. Second one is IoT system should be scalable, means time to time the IoT system can be designed in such a way that it can be scaled down as per our requirement. The scaling is also one important feature because day by day technology is reduced and area is one of the most important constraint for the newly coming technologies. And all these, you know, IoT system is combination of various technologies. So all these technologies can be efficiently associated with each other with the help of one efficient architecture. So the associated architecture is also one important characteristics of the IoT, because the billions, millions of the devices or networks are interconnected with the help of internet. So the associated architecture is also one of the most important characteristic of our IoT. Also, you know that there are various billions of the devices are connected with the help of the internet, or various number of sensing devices are connected, and overall our network systems becomes very complex in nature. Then how you recognize these devices? We can recognize these devices or these networks with the help of the naming and their addresses. So the second important characteristic of IoT is the unambiguous naming or the addressing. So the naming or addressing system should be unique for every architecture or every device. So this is also one of the most important characteristics, unambiguous naming and the addressing. Also in IoT there are various nodes. For example, in one system, suppose we are not using at that time, for example in the daytime there is no need of sending the information of the street light to the controlling station. So at that time there are various sleeping nodes. So in the IoT, the third characteristic is the sleeping nodes, mobiles and the non-IP devices. Mobiles means, suppose here we design one IoT system at this particular place and we want to use this IoT system at any particular place. So the IoT system should be mobile in nature, means this IoT system can be installed here, can be used here and can be used at other places. So this is also one most important characteristics of the IoT. And IoT, these devices should be non-IP devices, means suppose we are using this IoT system at this particular internet, fine, and if we move this system to other internet network, so if we fix the IP address of this particular devices, so if you use these devices in other network, so it will not work basically. So the IoT system should be non-IP devices based system, and this is also one most important characteristics of the IoT. Intermittent connectivity is also one important characteristics of the IoT, means intermittent means irregular intervals, right? So some intervals we need connectivity and in some intervals we don't need connectivity. So intermittent connectivity is also one important characteristic of our IoT. So next one is IoT market share. So from this figure it is clearly seen that there is a 16% of IoT share in the manufacturing
sector, 16% in the healthcare, 12% in the insurance sector, 11% in the banking sector, 8% in the retail and the wholesale, and 8% in the computing sector, and remaining one in agriculture, real estate, utilities, transportation, and the government. So, around 50% of the IoT share in the manufacturing, healthcare, insurance, banking sector. You know, in the manufacturing sector, one should know how IoT is beneficial for improving the supply chain, how the sensors can be effectively used to improve the manufacturing standards, to improve the manufacturing quantity, or to decrease the manufacturing cost. So all these can be done with the help of the IoT system. Second one important sector is healthcare sector. You know, the in the current scenario, the current situation, current COVID pandemic is the one best examples of the IoT share in the healthcare. Currently, our doctors or our nurses are getting infection in the corona wards. So these infections can be avoided with the help of the smart devices, with the help of the IoT systems. Or IoT systems can be designed in such a way that they can automatically measure the data, automatically attend the patient, automatically supply the medicine to the patient. So there is a minimum contact of our corona warriors with the patient. So this revolution can be made with the help of the IoT system in the healthcare sector. So basically, in the current, the 16% share is the before the corona the pandemic. Now this health, the 16% share is increased up to 30% due to this corona pandemic. Next one is insurance. So insurance sector should be smart with the help, can be made smart with the help of the IoT system. For example, suppose one accident happens at the highway, and automatically the information of this accident can be automatically sent to the insurance company, and the insurance persons can settle this claim automatically with the help of this IoT system. So life becomes very easy with the help of this IoT system. Next one is banking and the securities. All this is our internet banking, mobile banking, all these are possible with the help of the IoT system. Next one is our retail. So inventory tracking, smartphone purchasing, and anonymous analytics of consumer choices can be made with the help of this IoT system. So also the security, also one of the most important sectors where the IoT is used, for example, biometric, facial recognition, and the for all these systems or sensors are used to detect the person. Next one is evolution of IoT connected devices. Now we talk about the interconnectivity of the different devices. We see that the interconnection of connectivity between different devices have evolved over the years. So first it is started that individual first IoT system we can say, or first IoT devices we can say, that is the ATM. So this is the first one examples of the IoT. So with the help of these IoTs, persons can be withdraw the money and can send the money to other accounts. So this is one first revolution in the IoT, or first IoT connected devices. Second one is the web. So you know that everybody connect to the internet web in order to get the access of different information. Every information is placed on the internet, or with the help of the internet people can do the shopping, and people can search the things, and anything can be done with the help of the internet. And this is our second device of our IoT. Third one is our smart meters. So even like the smart meters can be programmed. So that's why the third revolution is the smart meters. You know, your bikes, there is this, these smart meters can be installed that can measure the speed. So this is the third connected devices. Next devices is, you know, the smart locks, or we can say RFID based locks. So currently we have, in various hotels or in various offices, these smart locks can be installed, or might be have seen that these locks can be like keyboard operated locks, or these locks can be operated with the help of the mobiles or with the help of the voice commands. So also this is one revolution which can be possible with the help of your IoT system. Next one is the smart healthcare. We already discussed about these things, because in the smart healthcare, like our robot can automatically measure the temperature with the help of the sensors and send this data to the central servers, and automatically with the help of the app we can book the ambulance, or the ambulance can search the patient on the priority basis, and automatically the healthcare system can be made smart with the help of the IoT. Next one is smart vehicles. Today a lot of smart vehicles are in the market, like which can sense the objects in front. Suppose in smart cars, when any object is in front of it, then automatically your brake can be pressed. So all these smart vehicles are available in our market, or automatically these vehicles can be connected with the help of the cloud, and the location can be tracked by the like number of your vehicle. Next one is the smart city. Smart cities is one of the most important area of the topic on which our current government is focusing very much. Also, Gwalior is one of the one example of the smart cities. Smart cities means all these combinations. Smart cities is the combination of all these technologies. Means our smart vehicles can be used in the smart cities. Smart healthcare facilities should be provided in the smart cities. Smart locks, smart meters, and all these things are connected. Sensors can be placed on the highways, and all these vehicles can be smart, and all garbage smart systems, garbage collection systems should be smart. So all these things collectively are the part of our smart cities. Next is our smart dust. Smart dust is basically a newly invented term. Smart dust is basically the nanoparticle which can be spread on the body, human body, and this automatically measures the problem in our human body. Like any disease can be measured, or any disease can be detected with the help of the smart dust. If the smart dust of these particles is placed on the earth, then it can automatically measure the condition of that particular soil. It means how many minerals are present here and other information like its humidity, temperatures, all these informations can be collected with the help of the smart dust. So basically these are our evolution of IoT connected devices. Next one is IoT applications. So IoT is used everywhere nowadays. So basically we are saying smart parking, which automatically sends, which automatically tell you about the parking status. Suppose in the smart parking, when you enter, then it automatically tell you that there is this, like 20 locations is available, or 50 location is available, or your parking is full, your parking is empty, or all these informations can be placed on the display when you enter in the smart parking. Next one example is health monitoring, urban maps, noise urban maps, like automatically noise can be detected, the like how much dB noise is placed in particular area, like smartphone detection, traffic condition, lightning system, waste management, smart roads, river flood measuring, automatically tank monitoring, tank level monitoring, like in our bikes, photovoltaic installations, water flow monitoring, stock calculations, like in the insurance market, stock market, intelligence shopping, earthquake detections, fire detection, pollution monitoring, snow level monitoring, landslide monitoring, and many more applications. So in every applications we can use the IoT. So basically there are trillions of sensors are used currently in the IoT system, or billions of the smart systems and trillions of the sensors collectively used for millions of the applications. So there are the three pillars of our IoT. First one is the smart system sensors, and based on this the millions of applications can be used the IoT systems. So in this lecture we learn about the basic definition of the internet, the combination of the internet and the things, the fundamental concept of IoT, IoT vision, IoT characteristics and applications also discussed in this lecture. We also discussed about the share of the IoT market and the evolution of our connected devices. So students, thank you for your kind attention. If you have any query regarding this lecture, then you can contact me directly through the mail. Thank you very much.